Let's go on to a question. I believe it's via voicemail, yes, if I'm not mistaken. So let's go ahead and hear this question.
If you kill someone in self-defense, say they broke into your house or trying to rape you or something like that, how does God feel about that, and are we allowed to do that?
So here we have a question about killing and self-defense and you know, something that maybe a lot of people question, especially when it comes to self-defense. How do we handle this question? How does the Bible handle this type of question?
I think you have to look at the Ten Commandments. That's probably where this you know, call is coming
thou
from.
Thou shalt not kill.
Sixth commandment, thou shalt not kill. That word kill in the Hebrew means murder.
Okay.
So it's talking more along the lines of intentionally taking someone's life. It's not talking as if it was an accident or self-defense, but you murdered that individual. You purposed in your heart to take that individual's life.
We also can add that, of course, ideally, we should not take a life of anyone, because God is the only source of life. And so when we kill someone, this is irreversible. And so we cannot resurrect this person.
That's right.
And sometimes, you know, even in defense, people do it by mistake. I mean, mistakenly taking life of a wrong person. So it also is a possibility. At the same time, we can also add that in the Old Testament, we have a provision for people who kill somebody accidentally.
That's correct. Yeah.
Okay.
And we know that, for example, if we look at the Joshua chapter 20, book of Joshua chapter 20, from 2 to 4, we can read that tells the Israelites to designate the cities of refuge as they instructed you through Moses, so that anyone who kills a person accidentally and unintentionally may flee there and find protection from the avenger of blood. When they flee to one of the cities, they are to stand in the entrance of the city gate and state their case before the elders of that city. And then the elders are to admit the fugitive into the city and provide a place to live among them. So we can say and conclude that though God is the only source of life, and I think he hates killing, but he differentiates between the different cases. And also the cities of refuges, we know that six cities were set aside for these cases, three to the west of Jordan and three to the east of Jordan. And strategically, they were placed during the one-day travel so that people can easily and quickly reach them in case if something tragically happened. Of course, this question does not deal with maybe unintentional, but I think that we should always keep in mind that ideal purpose is not to take life of anyone.
Yeah,
and that's important because the Sixth Commandment, although it prohibits killing, murder, it's really talking about preserving life. And I can understand that. You know, I was sharing earlier how I had an accident, car accident, several years ago when I was pastoring in Brooklyn, New York, and unintentionally hit a woman who was walking across the street against the light, and she died. Now, you're talking about the pain and anguish and the guilt of taking life that the Bible says is sacred. It comes from God. We were created in the image of God. But then, as you just said, God doesn't compare or list all types of killing on the same level. There's murder when you intentionally do it, and then there's the unintentional taking of life. But the Sixth Commandment really focuses on, even though it says, do not kill, do whatever you can to preserve life.
Absolutely. And I think there is this sense of, you know, no matter how the life is taken, accidentally or through murder, there is this sense of pain that, that someone goes through. And I think that, that there's hope here in what the Bible is stating. And even in those levels, and while you were stating that, I said, wow, even God thought this through. That this is something that, that people will seek for.
Yeah, interestingly, the cities were ruled by Levites, who were like mediators between people and God.
So God had a plan.
He always does.
Always does.
To redeem and to stop the additional bloodshed.
Amen.